soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my trail, but I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day, but I'm watching while I pray. No matter the attack, I won't turn back, 'cause this means war.
As you see, there's a woman behind me doing her war dance.
Hey, Glover.
Think the song was, "This Means War." Sometimes you have to declare war. And some of you only know war from the card game, "I Declare War." You like to cheat. So, and then what was his name? I was asking Chris, but he's too young. But his name was Evan Starr. He had a big song called "War, What Is Good For?" And you go, "Oh, absolutely nothing. Say it again." But sometimes you have to declare war against the enemy. It doesn't mean that it's going to be a vicious battle. You just have to be prepared for the fight. How's everyone doing? Hope everyone's doing fine. Is it a wonderful Wednesday day? Is a beautiful day outside? Well, any day you're alive is a beautiful day. But the sun is shining. It's a beautiful California sun shining. Hot day. I think it's going to be like in the 90s or something today. So enjoy yourselves. Now, as far as Uncle Isaiah is concerned, I know it's going to be hot, but make sure if you're going to wear something outside that it fits you appropriately. All right. If you're going to put on a little top, make sure it's a little top for a big person, not the other size. Because, you know, I don't want my eyes to hurt or anything like that. So put on the proper attire when you go out in the public. When I came up, Chris, we couldn't go outside, nor could we go to the store unless we looked proper. We couldn't jump out the bed in our pajamas and go to the store. You had to get up, you had to comb your hair, put a little Vaseline on your hair, your face, whatever you do, put on your good shoes, and then you went to the store, and then you came home. And all the kids had to be cleaned up that they went to the store too, but they don't do that anymore, but that's old school. That's what we used to do. Sister Faye won't be here today. She took a little vacation. I think she went to Jamaica, the Bahamas, or Chris, or was it Hawaiian Gardens or Compton? She went somewhere. She might have went to Linwood, but she won't be in today. So we wish her well. And as they say, traveling grace and mercy, she'll be back soon. Sister Crystal, you know, she just finished dancing, doing her exercising. So she is sort of tired, so she just went back to refresh, and she'll be back in a moment. So, Chris, how was your week? He says his week was good. He's hiding his face because, you know, he's under the witness protection program, and we don't want him, you know, we need him here. We don't want him to go back in authorities, but we'll keep him around here. Had a pretty good week. Had a few things come up. But it was all right. It was all right. We made it. We all go through challenges. The problem is face the challenge and come through the challenge and you'll be good. We're going to share a couple of things with you today. I got a couple of videos I bought in I'm going to share with you. wanted to say, Sister Crystal's back. Let's give Lady Crystal a hand. She's in the room after declaring war, doing the stump. That used to be called the stump.
Baby, that was the stump.
There was a stump that was called the L.A. Before the Crip Walk, it was called the L.A.
LA
stump. Stump. Come
oh,
on
wait,
now.
Hold up. How it go?
Let me see. You had to do it with the one. There you go. That's the L.A. stump. That's the L.A. stump. Also.
Can you see my foot?
Now move the other foot, too.
Oh, what the other one do?
The other one. Move the other one, too.
How?
Move the... There you go. Now, come on.
Uh-uh.
Okay, now that's the beginner's Holy Ghost dance. If you can't do it too well in the church, see, that's how you get it. Yeah, that's the L.A. stump, and then James Brown came with Get on the Good Foot. Hey. Did you get on the good foot?
Do I remember? I don't know how. If, was it a dance?
There was a dance for James Brown. Well, you know, there was a dance for everything James Brown did. James Brown danced for
That's
the time he,
that.
Supposedly, from
that.
When he came out the room.
Uh-oh.
When we were small,
when we were small,
when the company came, remember this? When your parents had company, we were sent to the room.
Yeah.
We couldn't sit up with the company. But there was one person that could come out of the room, and that person was the entertainer. If you were the child that had entertainment in your blood, you came out and performed for the people. So in your case, Crystal, they might have said, Chris, come out here and sing a little number. And Crystal came and sang a little number, and then go back in the room.
Well, wait, you know what they did for me, though? That's what they did with me. They didn't have me singing because they didn't discover my singing abilities at that young. But they would let me play the pie pan like a tambourine because they thought I could play the tambourine. So it was like, get that pie pan, go and watch it. You know, I was like 9 and stuff. You know, that is so funny. He said
my
the entertainer
cousin,
could come out of the room.
Yes, my cousin was allowed to come out. Shouts out to J.J. Neal. My cousin was allowed to come out because he could do the James Brown.
Are you serious?
J.J., come do the James Brown for the people.
Oh.
He do the James Brown and go back in the room and sit down.
Can I get a cookie or something?
Oh, no. You know, we got a cookie, but we also got what we call a palette. Now you're looking at me like you don't know what a palette is.
You laying out on the floor, palette?
Chrissy, you know what a palette is?
Chris don't know.
A palette is, it can be any kind of a cover.
Yeah.
You put it on the ground, mm-hmm. because there's not enough chairs in your bedroom for all your cousins. You put it on the ground, mm-hmm. and everybody's on there. And you might cover it with some newspaper when they bring in the sandwiches.
Oh, with some newspaper.
Because they bring in the sandwiches and the Kool-Aid. Because you're not coming out the room. You're not coming out the room. You get your sandwiches and your Kool-Aid. You can come out sometime if you're going to the restroom.
That sounds like a bedroom picnic. Yeah, the picnic in the bedroom.
That's what it was.
And that is so cute.
And then after they cleaned up, if they were still doing something, then everybody move, clean your pallet spot because that was your bed for the evening. Lay on down on that pallet. That's old school.
You remember all that stuff.
See, well, but see, the young people are spoiled. Chris is spoiled. Chris probably knows what it's like to have his own bedroom. Maybe even his own bathroom.
Probably.
We didn't have that. We had 20 people with one bathroom, and you stood in line.
Had to wait.
Mm-hmm. You had to stand in line and wait.
It's such a gift to these young people, the life that they have. It's a gift.
It's a gift in a way it backfires on you sometimes. Because you tell them, turn on the TV. Can't turn it on. Why? There's no remote. They don't realize there's a button on the television.
Uh-oh.
You know, go push
change the
button.
Channel and off and on.
Well, even when the remotes came
He's
on,
so
you know what parents used to do.
School,
even though there was a remote control, they still wanted to use us.
Get up,
Crystal,
and go turn
come change this to Channel 7. Mama, the real. Change it to Channel 7, I said, girl. And then the old kind of remote Baby. Control. Let's go back to the TV. Let's go back TV before
oh
we got a little
gosh.
Change. Before you got changed.
Who cares?
What
I
was the
like
antenna?
TV.
What was your antenna?
I remember we used to use pliers to change the channel.
Pliers? So you can go to UHF.
And we used aluminum foil and coat hangers.
There you go. And sometimes you got stuck in an awkward position because you were straightening
out. Hold it right there.
I can't see that. Hold it right there and shut
That's
up.
That's a shame.
Hey, but we came up, though. We
were servants as little children. We were little servants.
We were
I ain't gonna call us slaves.
Bring me a sandwich. Bring
me
something
servants.
To drink.
We learned how to serve our elders. But that's good knowledge, good teaching. Because if you grow up serving your elders, guess what? You're going to continue to have that spirit of service in you.
Well, not only
service,
elders. You service elders, and there was a sense of respect.
Right.
There were certain things you would never say to your parents.
Oh,
or
you better
your
know that you slapped upside the head.
And these young kids would kind of say anything they want to say, But we were taught to respect. And if an older person came in the house, if we didn't know that person's last name,
you had to
do what? You had to say Miss Carolyn or Mr. Bob. You had to attach something to it.
Handle on that name.
That's right. You stayed in your place. Those were some beautiful times. I'm glad I came up with them.
I think it instills some wonderful values in me.
That I hold dear to this day.
I agree.
And I teach them to young people this day, because some of them, they come up and try to say, I said, who are you talking to, boy?
I knew that word.
Boy, who are you talking to? Would you address me? I know I look young, but I'm a senior citizen. So when you address me, you'll put a mister in front of that.
Okay.
All right, hold on. Got a little trivia coming on.
Got your video up?
Chris, I'm going to ask Chris.
What?
Why did James Brown make everybody call him Mr. Brown?
Because he didn't want the white man. I don't know.
Because he was disrespected as a child. Even back then, black men were never called by their last name. So when he made it, you're going to call him Mr. Brown. You don't care who you are. And he had enough money to make the white people do that. Come up and pat him on his back. Well, James. No. Mr. Brown. I paid the cost to be the boss. Now, speaking of music, I found some videos I used to use, and I want to share a couple of them with you.
One of the things, music
is a powerful vehicle.
Is this you in the video?
No, I'm not. It's some of my friends.
Oh, okay.
I'm sharing a little history here. Chris, get ready when I tell you hit the button.
Uh-oh.
I'm sharing a little history here.
Okay.
I like history. Boy. I like you to remember where you came from. You should know what you're doing, and you can grow from that craft, right?
Hold up.
Don't be peeking.
Those are your friends that I see in that little box.
Don't be.
They made your friends.
Don't be peeking. You're peeking right now. I want to show you a little history here.
Mm-hmm.
Music is a powerful industry, and especially you can say women in music. We have some powerful singers that came out of the black community. But what everybody forgets, they came from the church. Aretha came from the church.
That's right.
Whitney, Sissy Houston, Dionne Warwick came from the church. Gladys Knight came from the church. Yeah. All of them broke their teeth. They got their training in the teeth. Ruth Jones came from the church.
Who is Ruth Jones?
That's the great Donna Washington. She was a musician in the church. Her real name is Ruth Jones. She was named Donna Washington by Lionel Hampton when she was singing with Lionel Hampton.
He said, let's change that
from Ruth Jones.
That's a shame.
She was the organist, the church musician. Sarah Vaughn was a church musician.
Was her name something else?
Her name was Sarah Vaughn.
Oh, always.
Her nickname was Sassy.
Dude, wait, hold up. You know the wonderful, the legendary Smokey Robinson heard me sing in Jobet's studio. Do you know what he said?
What'd he say?
She sings like Sarah Vaughn.
High compliment.
That was in the 80s when I was young.
That was a high compliment. The distinction between Sarah Vaughn and everybody doesn't understand. Sarah Vaughn didn't have a voice. Sarah Vaughn had an instrument.
Ooh.
And that's how she used her voice as an instrument.
Like an instrument.
Instrument. So we're going to go back to the church. See if you can identify some of these women groups.
What's the name of the group?
You know, Beyonce, what was her group called? Destiny's Child, The Supremes. But before all of those, these women groups started it all for the secular and for the church world. Come on, let's have church. Hallelujah.
Walk right on the back.
All right, Chris, let me test your knowledge. The first group was who?
I'm going to say what, Chris? Because that Chris don't know. Now, this
Crystal,
Chris.
The first group was who?
I don't know, but I know that was...
No, the hold group.
Up. Oh, that was the Caravan.
Right. Who started
of,
the Caravan?
Because of Shirley Caesar and Cassetta George.
And who started the
and
Caravan?
And then Albertina Walker.
Albertina Walker.
So,
and who
yeah.
was their main musician?
I don't know.
James Cleveland.
Oh, I should have said
James
that.
James Cleveland. Now, yeah. and that you saw the great Shirley Caesar,
yeah,
who is
that's
still
what I was telling Chris about
the
other video. No, the second one.
Now, Shirley Caesar, she... How she got in the group, because she was much younger than the rest of the women. You know how she got in the group?
Really? What happened? What happened? Who? What?
How she got in the group, she went to a concert.
There it is. Uh-huh.
And she sent up a note.
Who?
And she said, I heard Shirley Caesar's here. Ask her to sing a solo.
Shut up and it
Shirley
was her?
Shirley sent a
note.
Somebody requested for me to sing.
No, she didn't.
Yes, she did. Yes,
who
she
told
did.
That story?
She did. And she's legendary right now. She went on, and most of you know her. She's the mother. You can almost call her the mother of gospel.
Shirley Caesar.
Right now. She's the mother of gospel.
I got Chris to find this video. Well, it came through Brother Lawrence Hill.
Okay.
He's getting ready to do something. We'll announce that in a minute, Lawrence. But play this video of Shirley Caesar probably around maybe 10 years ago, 20 years ago.
Okay.
Well, if it's all right with you, I'd like to try to sing God Will Take Care of You.
God Will Take Care of You. Howard?
Be not dismayed.
All right.
Whatever betide. God will, He will take care of you.
Great, mighty Shirley Caesar.
Yeah, she's still doing her thing today.
But another part of trivia where that's concerned,
in that
she
other
also
video.
Played on the Parkers.
Who?
Shirley.
She did?
Yeah, she was Nikki's angel. You remember that? She
no.
came down as Nikki's angels on
Get
the Parker.
Get out of here. I didn't see
now,
all
that.
They
show,
try to keep some gospel in those shows.
I think that show was called Amen. Was that show?
Was that Amen?
No. Amen was Sherman Hensley.
Yeah, I don't
this
know what
one,
that name was.
I can't remember the exact
but it
name of it.
But now that other group I saw on there was Clara Ward, huh? The Ward
You saw
singers.
Clara Ward of the
and
Ward
And all the
singers.
White people.
they
I
were
said,
at a...
Oh, my God.
They were at a festival. They were at a jazz festival.
That was a jazz festival?
That was a jazz festival.
And they had the gospel at the jazz
and
festival.
And what Clara Ward did,
That's
she
awesome.
Bought in the hair, the makeup, and all the fanciness.
Okay.
With that and the dancing. Because in every
thing?
Song,
no,
they would break
dance.
Down. Oh, no, they do the river dance. You break down. They were on the Flip Wilson show.
What?
They were one of the most popular groups out there. In fact, they were the opening act for Reverend Franklin.
C.L.
Franklin used to do concerts. Like somebody would now go to a concert to see Jay-Z.
Mm-hmm.
I had to say that so we can pull Chris back with us. He probably go, who the heck is C.L. Franklin? That
Aretha
was Aretha
Franklin's daddy.
They would sell, he would sell concerts. You wouldn't necessarily go to church to see him.
Oh, he would
Let's say he'd come sell out the Forum, and Uh-oh. He would sell
woo,
it out. People
woo.
Would come to see him at the Forum,
and
Clara
Ward
would be his opening act.
You better go ahead.
And the group in the middle, I'm surprised that this woman over here didn't recognize her own people.
Who was that?
Those were the Davis sisters out of Philadelphia.
My cousins.
They're your cousin. The great, the Pentecostal Davis sisters. They bought rhythm and they bought the feel to it.
Oh, really?
What happened when
That's
we came
Davis
from down
you,
south, when Negroes came from down south, when they came up north,
mm-hmm.
they were asked to sing in a stoic way. They were not supposed to show emotions, do gestures, or anything.
It, huh?
They were just to stand there and sing and maybe cross your hands like this.
Oh, but right. The Davis, I know this.
Yeah,
I
but the
that.
Davis sisters, no. She came, and the lead singer's name was Baby Sis.
I ain't holding my hand.
Baby Sis came, and she did gestures, and they did everything.
Wow.
Baby Sis was the inspiration for Sam Cooke. If Sam Cooke says, who's your favorite sis singer, he would have said Baby Sis.
Wow.
Look on YouTube and look this up, and you will see what I call, this is my saying, flat foot singing. These are people who sing. They're not pretending. They don't need so-called instrumentation. They're just singers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where it all started from. You're flat foot singing. You can sing it anytime. Plus, I think your feet are flat.
They are.
To say with that. So, Chris, that's old school. That's singing. That's good old church
singing. Bring the new papa up. You know, look, if my daddy was alive today, this would be something my daddy would have done, because this dude is suited and booted like my daddy used to be back in the 80s
I don't know.
And 70s.
Are we going
to
look at, can we look can at we little look clip? At,
just a little bit, just a little bit.
Can we look at little
just
clip?
Just a little bit, and then.
Because he got a new song out, but it's sharp.
Well, see, that, let me tell you, Dee Dee Davis.
Sharp as a tack.
From Louisiana, Friendship Town. You understand me? Friendship. He dressed in cowboy boots and cowboy hats and little bow ties.
Okay, now that you're saying all that, when did your father die?
He passed in 85.
Was he out here?
Oh, yeah, he lived out here.
Okay, so somewhere we went, I saw him.
I'm sure. Because, some of the churches, he either pick me up or drop me off.
Yeah, because when you just gave that example. Yeah. I saw that picture all in my face.
Daddy was no joke. Dude was off the chain dressing. So just play a little of that. I know you can probably capture it somehow. And then we can maybe take the video off and just leave the volume.
Come on, come on, come on. Here we go. My name Bishop Bullwacker, from the First Church, nothing but the truth. Deacon Kyle, Deacon George, Deacon Clay, open the door, let them in, turn them loose. First, I want to thank God for the blood running warm in my veins. That's all right. Thank God for my life, health, and strength. I got a sound mind, I'm not insane. Come on, come on. I ain't going to preach too long. Ain't going to take the service too far. My sermon this morning, hell to the no, no, no. Come on, come on, come on. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no, no, no. Listen, Sister Edda, Sister Ruth, y'all ushers, make sure that everybody get a seat. Sister Lily may go in the kitchen, cause when I get through, I need to eat.
You know what I mean?
What you say?
The thing about it, like I said, mommy or my daddy, and that's what the old folks would say, something like that. So just keep listening to the song, y'all. We just gonna party with the song, okay? How about that?
I got some people there looking for some blessings, but now God got to get the praise. There's an old saying, when the praises go up, you get the blessing coming down.
Yeah,
I got some peoples in the church, huh? And they still, they're messing around. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no, 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 no. Listen, I got peoples in the church today hugging you. They claim that they love you to death. They'll do that. But time to get home, they on the telephone talking about they can't stand your breath. Yeah. I got peoples in the church smoking weed, drinking whiskey, drinking vodka, a lot of gin.
What you say?
I got the preacher with the night prayer meeting talking about can I get an amen.
Talk to him.
Every Sunday morning, about a quarter, about a half past ten.
Come on.
I got some faggots, got some bull daggers. I got some hoes and dope addicts, they're coming in.
That's right, that's right.
And now they're laying at the altar, and they confess the sin, their sin, yeah.
Come on, Bishop.
The time you see them Monday morning, doing the same thing again.
Come on.
Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 listen. I got kids dropping out of school, talking about they don't want to learn. But they're standing on the corner, rolling blunts, talking about come on, let's burn. they'll do that. I got kids walking up and down the street, pants hanging down by the knees. Look at them, look at them. About that, they're looking for a job. When I see them, I say, did it, bug, please. That's what they need to see. See all they ever talk about, brag about who got the biggest and the baddest gun. Time to see the copper with the bubble top. And they drop the Glock, they wanna run. Yeah, and now the sheriff got them locked up. Got them sitting in the county jail. What now? Heard the mama, she was crying all night, cause she can't get money for the bill. Now they're mad with the homeboys, cause they didn't put no money in the commissary.
Yeah, yeah.
Be glad you're in the jail, brother man, cause you were sure headed for the cemetery. That's a fact. There's an old saying that a hard head make a soft behind.
Yeah, yeah.
But since you did the crime, gonna do the time, stop the baby crying. Hell no, to the no, no, no. Hell to the no, hell to the no. To the no, 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 no. Hell no, no. To the no, no. Hell to the no, no. To the no, no, no.
Wow. Did you hear what he's saying? He's really dropping truth, reality, knowledge of what's happening in the streets. Did you hear that?
I heard that. It's some true things. And the other part of it,
what?
We can use that.
What you mean?
We can use that. You know, if you could carry... Oh, no, no, no. The cell phone. I just got a new cell phone. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And I just love it.
You did?
I just love it. I upgraded.
You upgraded?
Sometimes you got to come up.
I left
some of us
office.
Are staying down too long. Come on up.
Wow.
Come on up to Bright Glory.
Mm.
But anyway, I'll put that on my cell phone so it could preserve my voice. So
the
when
song?
People ask you stupid questions. No, just the chorus.
You put the song on your phone.
Just the chorus.
You put the chorus
like
on
a ringtone.
Song.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Are you
so when
serious?
Somebody asks me a stupid question.
No.
Uncle Isaiah, can I borrow $100? Hell no. To the no, no, no.
Uncle,
can I borrow your car?
Hell no.
To the no, no,
no.
Uncle Isaiah, can I spend the night? Hell no.
Oh, my
You know, it
God.
Can answer a lot of things.
You a mess.
Can I have a bite of your food? You're a woman. You don't get this. He's a man. He understands. We don't like sharing our food.
Oh, really?
We want you to have yours, and we're going to have ours.
I got mine.
We
got
will
you.
Even ask you on the way home, do you want something to eat? If your answer is no, we're not bringing you anything.
Oh.
If we know
Chris
you,
said, mm.
if we know you fickled in your mind,
oh my
we gonna eat something before we get there.
If you
if
fickled
we have to
in
get,
your mind,
because when we sit down and eat, we're not gonna ask you,
fickled.
Do you want something?
I used to be fickled.
And if you ask for a bite,
thank
we
God
gonna
I'm
get
delivered.
Mad.
I'm delivered.
So we gonna play hell no to the no no no. I know you're not supposed to say it every day, but it works for a lot of things. It will keep you out of problems, right? You running with the wrong group.
Number 7, Chris.
You can say hell no to the no, 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 I ain't going. It would have kept Chris out of problem.
My.
Chris wouldn't have 5 baby mama. And it said hell no to the no, no, no.
Chris who? Chris who?
Chris sitting over there. Who you
don't
talking about?
Don't get my Chris in trouble.
He would have.
That's my RMC son.
And?
Jessica be coming up here talking about, Miss Crystal, what are y'all doing up there?
And? But
I'm
anyway,
be like,
no,
Uncle Isaiah, start some stuff.
You know, that's just a, it's kind of funny. I just heard that on the radio. Just, I
but
didn't
you
know about the whole verse.
I enjoy the truth coming from the voice of the elders, speaking it in today's language. That's what I said. My daddy, see, my daddy was always hip. I remember my daddy started saying, soul brother. I remember he called his friend a soul brother. I said, oh, my God, my daddy done changed. You know, my dad used to preach. Why don't you lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus? You know. So then
so
he stopped preaching. Wait, hold on.
You,
he stopped preaching, stopped going to church.
Of the Davises.
He just started hanging out, wearing those loud color shirts, those red, all these flowers. And, you know, remember the 70s?
Yes, yes.
And then I heard him talking on the phone to somebody, soul brother. And I said, oh, my God. So the 70s affected my dad. He became a soul brother. And but, you know, it's their wisdom that we need today. It's the wisdom of the older man, just like you, Uncle Isaiah. We need your wisdom to help us to replenish the knowledge of the land today. So now my husband, you know, he's up there in age. I think he might be a little older than you.
Brother Wells. Let's hear it for Brother Wells.
I did a show Sunday here, and I engineered it and played all my music and stuff, my Wild Gospel CD and some other stuff. And so we were playing it yesterday, and he liked the song that I was playing, but he said I was talking over it. So he was like, he kept going back, you know, rewinding it. But he said he was blessed. He said it was like a miracle. He said even my voice, and he was talking about how it was anointed. I was like, this is what my husband talking about, man. So, to know that you can do something and you can really bless, one, your family, two, your husband, your wife, that's a big thing. That's a big thing, because most of the time, they don't think much. They think light of what we do. Oh, please, you know, just make us some. But he was blessed. So, I want to play this song and dedicate this song to my husband, Brian Courtney Wilson, Worth Fighting For, on the Wild Gospel 2015. And then we'll be right back, okay? Okay.
Deep in my despair, to show me you would never leave me there. You claim because I was made for so much more. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Oh, heavy with the weight of my mistakes, you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love. There's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path, opening every door. I am your child, and I'm worth fighting for. Nothing can separate me from your love. When there's so much more, yeah. The marks, cause the calling on my life is worth fighting for, and I'll keep my mind stayed on you, Jesus, because the peace it brings is worth fighting for, and I'll be faithful to my wife and children, because my family is worth fighting for. World is not my home, but your kingdom here is worth fighting for. I got a mansion over in glory, and my new home is worth fighting for. Till I see it, I'll shout out
Brian Courtney Wilson.
Yeah.
He's been out for a little bit, but he hasn't gotten the attention he should have garnered. I want to share a little thing. I saw him live.
You did.
And when I'm talking about a not just a professional, but an anointed singer.
Mm-hmm.
He did an album maybe about 2 years ago, and it had some songs on there, but one on there called Awesome God. I just want to hear a little piece of that.
Awesome God, awesome.
So
God.
Look him up on YouTube. Oh yeah,
Brian Courtney Wilson.
Brian Courtney Wilson.
Lord, Lord.
You're talking about an inspiration.
That's good worship. That's good worship. And that is really what we need. We need more good praise and worship.
Without the so much presentation.
What do you mean?
What I mean in that some people get caught up in putting on an act.
Well, of course.
But you have to hold on. When you put on an act, you have to realize that I first have to become used to your act. Before I actually listen to what you're saying.
Too.
Right. But I like somebody who just comes out and lets the music do the work.
Yeah.
He just comes out in his plain suit or whatever. They start playing. He plays instruments, but he has a musician and a band.
But wait, you're
but
talking
he also
about...
does full acapulco.
Oh, God. Acapello. Hey, got Lady V.O. in the window. What's happening, Lady V.O.? Brother Tracy Neely back there, too, I guess. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Y'all, come on in. Praise the Lord. Come on in the house. Come on in the house. It's going to rain. Now, listen, I was going to say, because you were talking about performance, that's what our people do. Our people perform. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How y'all doing? Cool. Our people perform, and they really performed in the church. I mean, look at Claire Wardell. They had rehearsed. They didn't just get up there and just start singing.
No, no.
She had it, I mean, to the T. When we do this, we're going to do that. And then we're going to come back and get the tambourine.
And then I'm going to hand you the tambourine back.
Come on now. So it was all. And then Kirk Franklin, was it just a show? I mean, he almost can beat James Brown doing his thing. We were talking about Kirk Franklin last week. You know, so we really do perform. And it's like we are trained to perform so we can get the most out of our, you know, what we're doing. I mean, come on now.
No, I agree with that. What I'm saying, your performance should complement what you're doing, not distract from it.
Well.
Let me tell you this. Gladys Knight, when she wanted me to be a pimp, I said, you already got three. You don't need another one, Glad.
A pimp?
A pimp.
A pimp.
You know that's how us Negroes say it. But it's really pip.
Pip.
Pride in perfection, pride in performance. But anyway, the pips, what they did, They added to what she was doing. They never took away from it.
They were
in the background, so they were smooth. It add. So when you went on the midnight train to Georgia, you knew you were going, but you had to wait for the pimp to say, boom, woo.
No, they didn't. Woo, woo.
You had to wait for boom, them to woo. Say that. Come on with it. I'm not a singer.
Now look.
But that's what you added to it, and that's what made it perfection. Now, hold on just one moment now.
What?
Just one moment since Uncle Isaiah was off a couple of weeks. Now I'm freed. I'm back.
Oh, Lord. Where are you? You went off two
You know,
weeks.
I like to do history things. I like history.
You got 1 minute.
I have one more little clip I want to introduce you to. Go on YouTube and search some of these things out.
You ain't got time for no YouTube?
As we stay. No. It's a good history lesson,
oh,
teacher.
God.
It's better than television.
You know, you I didn't like school back in the day. Don't be trying to bring me to school.
Some historical things. But anyway, we started today. We started with, we had the Claire Ward singers,
yes.
Right? Then we had your cousins,
you had
the famous
Caravans.
David sisters.
Yeah, you had the Davis
Then
girls.
We had the Caravans. But the woman that put black singers on the map, just not gospel singers,
who?
But black singers, period, who toured Europe extensively, was the great Mahalia Jackson.
Oh, really?
And I want to show you her doing something different than singing. Just
she
a little
danced.
Clip.
Was she dancing?
No. Just
Does
a little
he know
clip.
Where it is?
Here we go.
You
he
got
knows
Chris.
What it is. Chris and I work together. Don't
Chris.
Come between me and my grandson.
Our mystery challenger, for which, as you well know, my colleagues all blindfold themselves. Are the blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? All right, panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Betsy Palmer.
Are you female?
Yeah.
Mr. Sir?
Would you possibly be called a songbird?
No.
I would say yes to that, though, Bennett. This is you're taking this in a broad term of reference, I take it, right?
Well, I mean, sings professionally.
Mm-hmm, that's right. And the answer is yes. Miss Francis?
Are you at the present time singing in a musical in New York?
No.
One down and nine to go. Governor Quinn?
Do you sing in a cabaret here in town at the present time?
No.
Two down and eight to go. Miss Palmer?
Would you say you sang more in motion pictures than in anything else?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you ever sung at one of the fashionable nightclubs or hotel rooms in New York?
No.
Four down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
This lady's out of work.
Four down. Four down and six to go, that is, by the way.
Now, wait a minute. No motion picture singing,
no
nightclub singing. No.
Arlene, let me correct you. The question on motion picture had to do whether the... Our guest had sung more in motion pictures than anywhere else. We did not say no motion pictures.
I see. Well, I don't actually, but anyway. What have we left out?
Opera.
Opera? Are you an opera singer?
No.
Oh,
five
well.
Down and five to go, Governor Quinn.
You are not... Now, how do I get a yes answer to this? Let me see.
Not even.
Oh, it doesn't make any sense. You're not primarily known for your singing, are you?
Yes.
Yes. Our guest is primarily known for her singing, No You Get. That makes it six down and four to go, Miss Palmer.
I bet your voice is lower than what you're using, isn't it?
No.
Well, I would say this. We'll give you a qualified yes, Nebby. Our guest range is astonishing sometimes.
Oh.
And it can be low, but it is not necessarily lower than the voice you're hearing. It's very subtle right now, Mr. Sir.
Have you ever starred in a picture with Gene Kelly?
No.
That's seven down and three to go, Miss Francis.
Are you the great lady that sang the Star-Spangled Banner at the opening of the inauguration yesterday?
Well, wait a minute. We've got to be more specific.
Oh, well, wait a minute. I got
What did our guest say? Never mind, John, what you said.
No, I'm not going to tell you anything. I want to be absolutely clear about the question.
Well, I'll tell you, I was thinking of Marian Anderson.
No, that's 8 down and 2 to go, Governor Quinn.
Oh, my heavens.
Oh, but the...
She said she did sing at inauguration.
Did you mean you sang at the gala?
Yep.
Miss Palmer? Yes, at the gala. Miss Palmer?
Oh, who sang?
Oh, I wasn't there. Everybody else was.
I was there. Can I tell?
You were tell.
Was it Mahalia Jackson?
Right.
That's
gosh,
clip
he had to go the long way around.
Years ago.
What's my line? Kellogg's is still in business. Yeah, I got to call Kellogg's so they can promote my show. That was cute. I thought she was going to sing or dance or something.
Yeah. No, you know they usually have... celebrities of the time on there. So that's one of our celebrities that made it to
my time.
Show.
That was 5 minutes of my show for some.
That was phenomenal. That was history.
Yeah, it was. It was.
You wouldn't be singing as hard as you do without Mahalia.
You know, I saw
Mahalia
when I
got thrown
girl.
Out the church for you.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, look.
She would shake when she would sing. They'd make her put on robes because they didn't want her moving and gyrating. Yeah.
Glory, glory. Hallelujah. Okay, look, we got Love Jazz in the house. And so, how y'all doing?
Hey, we're doing great. Doing how
really
you doing
great.
Today?
Love is in
all
the air.
All is well. Praise the Lord. Love is in the air.
It's in the air.
Yeah,
and we ain't loving this money, but we love what it can do. Hey. So y'all make y'all donations. So, you know. Now, look, we are raising funds around here.
I know.
For some of our shows, for some of our works that we like to do, workshops, and things that we like to provide for the community. We want everybody to lend a helping hand. It is a little something in there, ain't no change. So that means it's some dollar bills, not just paper. There's some dollar bills in there.
No IOUs?
No IOUs.
Oh, okay.
So we want to get this thing filled up, and I need 1,000 people. Come on in, come on in. I need 1,000 people to send me how much?
$1,000.
Okay, whatever number we agree on, we're going to say 1,000 people to send us what?
$1,000.
Okay, he said 1,000. He backed him up. What do you say, Sister Lady VO? 1,000 people to send us what? What denomination of money?
$5,000.
1,000 people to give us $5,000?
He went up.
Jesus. I need to stare around these people more often. Maybe my whole life will come up financially because I was going to say, I ain't going to say what I was going to say.
Start with 5,000 because I feel like if we do 5,000, the people that really have money, they'll really know that it's serious and they'll really go ahead and reach in their pockets.
So we're going to ask 1,000 people to give us $5,000.
Right.
Now, how much would that be? Would that be $500,000?
Well, 5,000 times 1 is 5.
Is that going to be $5 million?
Okay, hey, look at 5 times 1 is 5.
That's 5 million?
500,000.
5 million. Chris said it's 5 million. If 1,000 people give us $5,000,
mm-hmm.
Chris said that's $5 million. That's right.
Chris?
500,000.
Is that right?
Yeah, but Chris, I anoint you a deacon of the church, which means if you said it's 5 million and it comes up short, you got to make up the difference. That's the way I was raised. When they counted that offering and they gave that paper to the pastor,
he
if it
not
was
be
short, missing. The deacon
so let me
gotta
get
make
the calculator.
Up. So
so my girl say 1,000 people to give $5,000. Now, I hadn't taken it up that high, and I'm ashamed to say what I taken it to. What is it, Chris?
What were you gonna do?
$5 million.
Oh,
that's what Chris
million.
Said. I got two computer. Rise calculators coming at me saying $5 million.
The deacon
so
and
there
the
it
trustee.
Is. We need $5 million. And that means that's $1 million for each of us in here.
So
that means we have a charge to do $1 million worth of work.
Mm-hmm.
So that means we're going to teach, we're going to facilitate, we're going to provide, we're going to present $1 million each worth of business. Now the house will get its cut. You'll get your percentage. And the rest will go for the services. Now this is real talk. $5 million. I got five people that's backing it up. It's nothing too hard, especially when we do work together and we have a not just a common cause, but a needful cause. Mm-hmm. Many people need housing. Many people need transportation. They just need food. They need a place to come and do some work. Some people need a place to work, not only to live, but they need a place to work. So if we can provide all of that, if we can provide jobs, if we can provide business opportunities, if we can provide all this stuff, new equipment.
Right now.
We need music equipment. We need new computers. We need recording equipment. We need everything that is needed to get the job done. So people that are in the business, people that it's the tax write-off season, we're asking 1,000 people to give $5,000. We can also flip it around. 5,000 people give $1,000. But the main thing is we talking about $5 million. How to reach $5 million. So 1,000 people. And you probably know 1,000 by yourself.
That's right. Come on now.
You know 1,000 by yourself.
Somebody about to call in right now to try to, you know, donate something in right now.
You know 1,000, right? Don't we all know at least 1,000 people?
I know there's some people on there listening right now that knows that all of us, at least one of us, and who we are and what we represent.
Mm-hmm.
And by them looking at us on TV and hearing what we're trying to do, because we are Love Jazz on purpose. We have a purpose on being who we are. Love Jazz, Tracy Neely, the great.
Yes.
And, you know, I'm Lady V.O. You know?
Well, you know, I wanted to say that I enjoyed your YouTube videos, your music videos, your performances with the Cotton Club. You really bring a great show. And as I was saying, I would like for you two to step out from behind those instruments for a little skit or something and show your love, how you, you know, show that love toward each other.
We would like for you to come
see our show,
and
then
you
will see what we really do.
We do all of that.
When's your next performance?
That was just one idiom of what we do.
Well, they're going to be here.
No,
actually, we're going to be here Friday.
We're going to be here Friday live on RMC Radio. And we're trying to develop some things and develop sponsorship and develop a forum for other musicians and other businesses. We
want
to start a networking show here.
Right here.
So that we can actually attract and, you know, we want to develop our LLC so that we start doing a lot of fundraisers so that we can really do exactly what the sister's talking about this morning.
That's
facilitate businesses that are geared towards the youth, geared towards the community, geared towards bringing and edifying our businesses.
That's it.
Bringing them upward. Because if we have something to fall back on each other, we won't have to ask anyone else for anything.
Exactly.
We must develop ourselves. If we develop businesses, if everybody have their own businesses, no one will have to come and ask us for anything. We'll be given what we need to give.
Especially
we won't have to ask anyone. We don't want to have to ask anyone for anything.
That's all right.
The whole thing within the community is we need to build our own self.
Give me a knife.
Build our own businesses. Build everything us and start supporting each other. If you see my brother's over here doing something, come to it.
Right.
Yeah.
Don't worry about how big it's going to be.
Support
make it big.
Make it big.
We got to start thinking, we're going to make you big. We're not going to hate
we're
on
gonna
you.
We're going to make you big.
That's big.
Right.
I'm going to make you big. And that's what Love Jazz is going to do.
And that's what
we're
trying to do this Friday. We want to start something over here on Fridays with her. If she has something going on Friday, we want to have all the musicians start coming down there supporting at the same time.
Right.
Supporting
we'll
each
call
other.
Them. Let me tell you this.
Somebody
say
different
this.
Play every week.
Let me say this.
So everybody can be familiar with each other. So this can be number one station, because this don't have no business not being number one black station, because it is all black.
Let me say this. You have to call them. This is where we were talking about. We know 1,000 people. Each of us know 1,000 people on our own. If we begin to call those people and invite them here, invite them to tune in, it will create itself.
Right.
Using this, that because we're going to be here, we're advertising on Facebook.
So you're going to be on the Gennardo Abrams show, Stop the Violence.
Yes, yes, and that's why we're going to be on the show.
I was going to play his CD. I'm going to give it to Chris, and we're going to
give them the number.
Create here, Chris.
That's why, like, we want to be on the violence, show, because we love
your
jazz.
Talents.
And
stop,
we exude
the violence.
Stopping the violence.
Stop
that's
the violence.
That's
use
our purpose.
Your talents.
Most people, when they hear love,
yes,
it they don't have it, so it deflects them.
Yes.
But hey, have it for yourself.
Yes.
Then
for yourself.
When you hear it, it's on and cracking.
For yourself.
And
wow.
That's what we're about. That's why we're going to be on the Stop the Violence show, because we're about love.
That's
when
awesome.
We put these waves of music, of love, across the airwaves, it could possibly soothe the savage beast, and that's why we're
here. Well, definitely it does. It draws, it attracts. We're going to put that CD in that Gennardo has. I don't know which one, maybe number two, Stop the Violence, the reggaeton mix. But then I also want to let everybody know the Taste of Soul is coming Saturday, October 17th. So get ready for the Taste of Soul. If you want some more information, you can go to tasteofsoulla.org, tasteofsoulla.org. We hope to partner with them. Or you can call 323-299-3800. And I also want to give a shout out to Ms. Gigi Pink. My girl Gigi Pink is come to bring her etiquette training to the young ladies. She's also providing workshops in the area of modeling and fashion design, and she has her pillow talking. So if you like more information on Gigi Pink, you can go to ggpink.com. That's GIGIPINK.com. ggpink.com. Also rmconair.com, Classic Soul Radio. I want y'all to tune in to the internet radio on Classic Soul, and also rmcgospel.com. We have our gospel radio channel there, gospel music going on 24/7 on rmcgospel.com. And also our DJ J Swish, Jordan Moore, DJ, audio engineer, and beat maker. So you can hook up these young people, get them involved. DJ J Swish at gmail.com. DJ J Swish at gmail.com. If you want more information, you can call me 323-239-9439. Our time is up, so we're going to go with that song.
Could you give them our call-in number for Friday? Do we have a special?
323-965-1600. If you'd like to call in on this Friday show
live
for Stop the Violence radio
and
internet
jazz.
TV show, and talk to Love Jazz, listen to Love Jazz this Friday, 3 to 4.
Mm-hmm.
3 o'clock to 4. P.M. right here in this studio on this channel. So right now we're going to go to this song, and if you have any questions, you know what to do. Give us a call, 323-965-1611. Peace and blessings.
It's all about love.
It's all about love.
To another, I lost two brothers. I had to brace myself for that devastating news that since this act of violence, the people who did this took a code of silence. So they caught them off balance. Now I have to express myself with my God-given talents. Sometimes we win, sometimes we lose. Any way you look at it, we all have to pay our dues. Stay on your P's and Q's. God gave us an offer we shouldn't ever refuse. Stop hating on people you haven't walked in their shoes. My brother's case is a mystery with a lot of clues. Temples flaring up like a stick of dynamite with a short fuse. I keep preaching nonviolence. Let's show the world our talents. That's what we gotta do to get this breakthrough.
Stop the violence.
Yeah.
Use your talent.
Come on.
Stop the violence. Use your talent.
Never stop, winners keep going continuously. Are you feeling me? A positive mental attitude, sound physical health, put you in the right mood. Oh yeah, harmony in human relations, free.